So we are all learners today. That's the first thing probably we have to have in our mindsets. Are we ready to learn something that is new? Are we ready to unlearn something which is redundant and not required? And relearn if it is required, and keep on learning and learning unless I reach that point, a vision for 21st century learners.
The concept is, having moved from education field into the e-learning content development company for the past 3-4 years, and having used technology for the last 10 years and been teacher for 30 years, having set up 3 schools, moved from DPS in Mathura Road from 1977, coming to the present day schools, Raffles International, has been a wide change all through. Therefore, the world for sure has changed. Now the question becomes, why should educators care? All of us are sharing the concern. So we are aware of it. Technology has created connectivity, communities, and consequences of that we are all aware of. Connectivity, when we say worldwide website, we children say it whatever, whenever, wherever, ma'am. This is given already in the book. What is next from you? So are we ready for that? When we say AAA, it is anytime, anything, anywhere, ma'am, just give me a minute, I'll Google search and get the lyrics for you. That's how a child talks to me in the school. Homework given, project done. Never mind, ma'am. We have 10 websites on. I will search 1, 2, 5. My friends will do and will compile and give you the result tomorrow morning only. Where is the time limit? That's how the children are cooperating, collaborating, creating, and innovating. Are we the teachers, we the learners, educators, parents, ready for it? Is the question for all of us. As a result, what we are talking about, 21st century learning model concepts have changed. And new age curriculum and skills, which all schools and educators are talking about, have actually come into practice. So all these pictures are only for us to say that changing mindsets is what is essential for all of us as stakeholders, parents, investors, teachers, principals, in everything. We have to accept the digital learners of 21st century. Do we understand them? What creates meaning for them? How do they learn, and do they like to learn, is also a big question. If they use Facebook or MySpace or any kind of social media, are we the teachers ready to use that media for teaching for them? So changing mindsets is talking about the new language that the children are using and the immersive media, and I use a multiplying sign there because the way it is multiplying, they're rapidly moving around. So changing mindsets, that accepting the challenges of teaching in a digital era, which everybody is talking about. Are we really preparing ourselves for the new forms of learning being enabled? Visual arguments which the children have on the system, invent the kind of things that will work for their school. This is something where the teacher becomes invisible. Are we ready for that kind of learning environment, where the child is learning on his own, self-paced, self-directed, self-assessed, motivated, or nobody is competing with him, but the child is competing with himself or herself? Are we ready for that kind of thing? Some of the learning, are we ready for the evolving forms of pedagogy? Traditional classrooms changed with classrooms with PCs. Then came the digital content provision in classroom. And then came the teacher-led model in digital classes. Learning designs and learning outcomes. I'm sure each one of us shares that the performance of the children, the teaching learning process, the effectiveness increases. But the question still remains, are we using it the way it has to be used? So new concepts in education, information to knowledge-based society, rote learning to understanding of concepts, memory to critical thinking skills, competency skills to problem solving, cooperation to collaboration and creativity, and of course the communication. Confidence of to risk taking life skills. Am I ready to face failures in the classroom? Am I ready to say, no, I don't know it, I'll find out an answer as a teacher? Am I ready for that? Am I preparing my children for the situation where there is a recession and he gets a pink slip and he knows that this is a reality and I have to work harder for something else? Are we preparing the children for that? When I talk of developing IQ, I just don't say IQ is only intelligence, but maybe inspiring the child, maybe integrating my processes, maybe having an interdisciplinary approach in the classrooms, making innovative ways for teaching into the classroom so that we as learners, because teachers have to become facilitators. The world has changed. I can't say I'm the ultimate, I know the best, and that's all. So I can have so many meanings. Similarly, see what I talked about. Let's cooperate, collaborate, communicate. So that critical thinking and find out the answers for every questions of education that we talk about. E is reference to efficiency. Emotional, of course, is there. We have to be actually creating emotional stability among our children, for sure, with the kind of lifestyles that we have as on date. Last but not least, spiritual quotient that I talk about, so that we have ready for the highest exam called life. Now, we have been talking about 21st century education. These are various attributes which probably I presume the 21st century education should have. Integrated, interdisciplinary, technology, media, student-centered is the main line that we can talk about. This is the proposed framework that I feel that education should have, the framework for 21st century learning, where we talk about student outcomes in the upper part of the semicircle, and the lower part we talk about the support system. So education alone cannot, teachers alone or principal alone, because I have set up 3 schools, I know how investors talk to me. So we just cannot do anything unless there is support system for creating that kind of learning environment which I as a visionary or principal of the school want to do. There has to be a support for that. Technology as a tool for can be used for complete transformation of pedagogy, where we can talk about the theory of constructivism that we are talking about. We can talk about student-centered learning. We can talk about learning resource support. We can talk about professional development of each one of us, starting from the investors, administrations, people, parents, students, teachers, everyone, professional development. We learn to use mobiles for our own comfort, internet banking for our own comfort. But when it comes to taking digital content in the classroom, I do not know. That's what the teacher says. I've been doing teacher training programs extensively all across India, being a part of Next Education, and I know how the problems are there for actually integrating technology into education. That 3 minutes capsule which any e-learning company can provide is not enough. Teacher has to use it the right way in the classroom to integrate that while teaching, so that that teaching learning process is enhanced. That is the question that we all have to ponder upon. So technology as a tool can be used for everything, we all agree, but the problem is how to set it right. So you talk about curriculum, you talk about a learning environment, you talk about teaching strategies, you talk about assessments, anything you ask for, and support services of IT are ready to give us all the solutions to the educators. So support systems are there. So what are the issues that we talk about? They're all interrelated. Technology as a tool can be used for school management. You talk about any aspect, and any e-learning provider will say, one-stop solution, we have everything for you. Now the critical issue is technology. The question is not whether, but how technology can be useful in education. So how do I integrate into the system is very important for me. How we use technology in education is more important than which technology do we use. Because how do I use that lesson, which all of us have shared in the beginning also. How do I integrate that concept that is available to me on the net anywhere? 3D, 2D content, virtual labs. How do I use it in the class? One module can be used for n different number of things, and I have been demonstrating that, how to do that. You can use the same visual for paragraph writing, composing, language, and everything. So these are the certain questions, but remember that there are no technology shortcuts to good education. It's just like an oxygen, necessary for breathing. It's all about changing mindsets about everything, and I'm sure the things change. Can we change the mindset, learning to learn for both teachers and learners? By failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail is the question. Even the assessment patterns have changed when we talk about assessment of learning, assessment for learning, assessment as learning, assessment in learning. Changing mindsets is the need of the hour. Keeping pace with digital era is a must. Thank you, everyone.